Warning, this video is not intended to be racist. If you're easily offended, stop the video. Or leave a nefarious comment down below. Enjoy.
Hey, all you people, hey, all you people, hey, all you people, won't you listen to me? Oh, what I have is a sandwich, not just an ordinary sandwich. It's a sandwich made with jellyfish jelly. Oh, you got to try the sandwich, just an ordinary sandwich. It's a sandwich made with jellyfish, jellyfish jelly.
Just kidding. Here's the real video. Ha ha! Oh no, okay. I'm not gonna get weird. Okay. That was a mozzarella bite. Okay. Okay. Sorry, it was just a little bit, moment of quiet there for a second. So, okay. Judging from the title of this video, I just want to set the record straight. The voices that I do, they're legit. They're completely legit. But just a little bit of a disclaimer, too. These voices sound the way they do on my gaming headset, which is a Turtle Beach X01. And on 360, it's an X12. There isn't much of a difference, but that's the idea. So, hold on, let me adjust the camera. There we go. Much better. Okay. So it's basically the voices you're hearing on a gaming headset. You don't really hear the same accuracy coming from my condenser microphone. Let me show you. Screw you, gravity. Okay, this is what I'm using. This is a CAD U37 microphone, and it works pretty damn well. But the problem with that is, of course, it's mid-priced. You get what you pay for. That's why I ordered a new Turtle Beach headset, and I ordered a brand new condenser microphone. It should be here on Friday. And for some of the friends who have been keeping up with me on Xbox Live, they have until Friday. Because, you know, they say it will be here on Friday. And if it's not, you remember that video I played you, don't you? You're like, Stewie, where's my money, Brian? I'm getting real tired of you ducking me, man. I'm getting real tired of this. Don't make a fool out of me, man. That's me. Oh, so let me pick up my list here. It's like, wait a minute, you have a list? Yes, I do. Okay. So, actually, this video I'm recording is actually on my brand new desk. Yeah, that I got for the holidays. I mean, it's new, technically, as of now, because this is the first YouTube video I'm using this platform on. So, the voices that I do. I have a certain organized assortment of voices here, and I'm just going to go through them. Now, as I said before the video, the announcement guy, this is not intended to be racist at all. This is just to have some fun. I just want to show you guys how I do these voices. Or I'm going to show you that I'm doing them so you know they're legit. I'm not using a voice changer when I do these things. Yeah, and try not, you know, and like you said, you know, if you are easily offended, please stop the video. Or leave a mean comment down below saying how much of a douchebag I am. But set aside from that, okay. Okay, here's my list here. Voices, right? It's quite a list here. I mean, you've got a list that big for voices. It's like, yes. Okay. Anyway. Okay, so there are three different voices that I do. The top ones, they hit the highest of the list to get people's reactions all the time. And that's the Transformer and the Microsoft Sam. They kind of go toe-in-toe between one another. You guys leave down in the comments down below which one you think is more creative. I don't know the answer to that. Okay. Moving back a little bit closer. This is what we're gonna do now. I'm gonna do my Transformers, right? And also, they would think that the Transformer thing I do, like, that's actually real. Now, let me watch. Should I go like, Optimus Prime online? Or I'll be like, Megatron online? Sometimes I do my own generic, and this freaks people out. This really freaks them out. I actually make them think I'm like a military class orbital defense drone. For example, I'll be like this. Give me a second. Okay. I'm like this.
Online.
And people are like, what the hell was that? And I'm just like,
Tier 3 Odin class satellite comms array online.
rotating government access satellite comms array 85 degrees southwest of the current position. I'm like, what am I listening to? And all of a sudden, like, authorization code confirmed, termination inbound. And all of a sudden, like, Odin 4, class tier 3 nuclear missile, orbital defense online, shields 120%.
And all of a sudden, like, oh my god, what am I listening to? And all of a sudden, like,
orbital strike confirmed, coordinates received. Like, northern continent, strike.
And all of a sudden, like, I'm like, then I just do this.
ETA, 5 minutes, current location. Like, primary target, White House.
I'm like, oh god, we have a freaking transformer about to freaking take out the White House. Yeah, that freaks them out. That alone is a little level of a shock factor. Now, here's the other thing, too. This is crazy. I'll do this. I'm like,
hacking into internet mainframe, pulling IP. Like, firewall down, decryption available.
No, like, I'm talking technical to make them think I'm literally pulling their information off the internet, and people leave the party immediately because they don't want a transformer hacking them. But, yes, then aside from that, that was the transformer thing. So I'm like, now, basically, that thing you're hearing is called tongue bass in the beatbox world. See, look, watch. That's the transformer sound. Yeah, that's basically how we do it. Now, on to the next one. I'm trying to make this as quick as possible. Okay, we have Microsoft Sam. Now, everybody loves the operator, so I'm going to do it, and this time you actually get to see my face.
Dear doctor, wait customer, please press 1.
I can do better, hold on.
Dear doctor, wait customer, please press 1. To speak to a representative, please press 2.
My voice is a little bit scratchy, but I'm working on it. Okay, let me try one more time.
Dear doctor, wait customer, please press 1. To speak to a representative, please press 2. To make an appointment, please press 3. For more information, please press 4.
God, it sounds weird, though. Sometimes it's on and off. It all depends. I don't know why. Sometimes it doesn't stick to my throat. Sometimes it does, but,
To make an appointment, please press 4.
No, and then, like,
to go fuck yourself, press 5. Local, local, local. You just got owned by Microsoft Sam.
And then people are like, just like that, right? But that's, you kind of get the idea. If you don't believe this is actually my Microsoft Sam voice, you can actually go to one of my previous videos in my video feed on how to talk with Microsoft Sam, because that's actually more accurate. That was the day when my voice actually was active. But seriously, people are like, what the hell was that? You hear that voice? I'm like this,
greetings, my name is Microsoft Sam. Windows D 2000 platform AI.
God, it sucks today. I don't know what that is. Anyway, then I goes like, I'm like,
discontinued model 2008 by Microsoft Studios, compatible with Windows 7, Windows 8, and Windows 10 platform.
Oh, god damn.
Compatible Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 10 platform.
Okay, got it. I think it sounds better when I take all the air out of my lungs and suck in. Because that voice you're hearing, I'm sucking in. I'm not going like, talk to a customer. No.
To talk to a customer, please press 1.
Like, I'm doing that. Hold on. I wonder if it sounds better if it does.
To talk to a customer, please press 1. To make an appointment, please press 2. For more information, please press 3. To go fuck yourself, press 4. Loadle.
Okay. Well, okay, those are just 2 voices we just covered. Okay, we got a lot more to go. Okay, we got Uncle Carlos. That's, if you guys kept up with me recently, everybody knows who Uncle Carlos is. Okay, here's the funny thing. So, Uncle Carlos, he's Mexican. And don't call me racist, because 85% of my friends are Mexican. Okay, basically a lot of these voices that you're hearing are accurate. The generic voices, of course, not like actual celebrities, I meant. But basically, all the generic voices you are hearing are basically referencing people I met in real life. So, well, here's the thing. So, Uncle Carlos, people are just like, hey, it's your Uncle Bar Carlos. If that's at the Mexico, make a stick of the border sometime, get you some tacos. You know what I'm saying, buddy? Man, you know, if you don't want the taco, you get the burrito, mojito, taquito, margarita, tajita, canita. And I was like, what the hell is that? So, basically, how that's working is, see the little bump on my Adam's apple?
I'm just pressing it in, buddy, and makes it work all the way.
You know, they get on spy, and I'll do this sometime. You know the John Cena meme? And his name is John Cena! Da, 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 da. No, I do like this.
And his name is Juanito the Mexican. Da, 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 da.
He's like, I bet you haven't heard of that wrestler before. But anyway. And that was,
That was Uncle Carlos, baby.
Let's see here. So he's like, that's just, you know, it's funny, that other voice you're hearing verbally, like,
this is what makes the voice go in, buddy.
The other stuff you're hearing, when you push in your Adam's apple, it gives you a lisp already, so it kind of works already.
And he's like, oh, yeah, hello, my name is Bukra, I'm from Sicaria. I'm not from the China provinces, or the Vietnamese, or the Thailand, or the Japan, no. If you want to come here from another province, go to shut the chopstick up your ass. Maybe you want a fortune cookie up your ass. Ooh, heck, I'm booty.
I'm like, what? That's basically an Asian guy. Asian boy, or whatever you call it. He's like, look, I'm a little difficult. I got some of his reference from Onage Pranks and another guy called, I know his name. He does Call of Duty trolling. I forget his name. I think you know what I'm talking about. His name is Shi Chen. Yeah, I'll figure it out. But yeah, but mainly the referencing came from Onage Pranks on YouTube. Now, here's another one. Now, you know, Sullivan Tucker, man, this is one of my favorites. His viewer's like, oh, goddamn, we got a country boy in the lobby here now. He's like, oh, we make DJ LaFella, dude, he's a country boy. I'm like, where are you from? I'm like, I'm from North Carolina. And I was like, dude, we've been to North Carolina. They don't sound anything like that. Oh, yeah, man, it's because I just recently got permanent residence there. And, yeah, basically, mainly, most of my life, I was born and raised in Kentucky. And then I moved to Louisiana about 7 years ago. And then I moved over here to North Carolina, got permanent residence here now. So that's currently where I reside. Stuff like that, and I was like, oh my god. And it was funny too, is that that voice you're hearing is actually people I met in real life, and I just reference how they sound and actually how they speak, which is pretty interesting. Okay, and that's a Sullivan Tucker. I'm a country boy living down the station, nobody will go. Alien, that's about the best life right there. You know, people's like, he's like, dude, are you high? I'm like, no, man, I'm hella drunk. Yeah, I mean, seriously, man, I mean, seriously, you haven't had a good time being drunk until you wake up naked, buck-ass naked in a dentist parking lot with the still had your wallet. I mean, seriously, if you got your wallet and you're naked in a dentist parking lot, you know you had a good time. I mean, seriously, by the time you're pissed out drunk, you wake up with a serious hangover, you gotta go into that dentist, buck-ass naked, get yourself some food. It will replenish your blood energy, your blood pressure, whatever you want to call it. And basically, you know, if they don't let you in, I mean, seriously, it's quite simple. Just plant your doobly against the glass, watch the children scream in terror, and just go, helicopter, 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 helicopter. I got that from a friend at school, but, yeah. I decided it's something I work out with here. Okay, now, Kool-Aid guy. People think I'm black for this. And don't get the wrong idea. This voice was intended to be the Kool-Aid guy. It really was. And so, basically, it's my Adam's apple again.
Kind of like when I did the Uncle Carlos, but I'm doing this voice, I'm pushing my Adam's apple in. When I do the Kool-Aid guy, I'm going to push it down.
So basically, I get right here, the bump, go above the bump, take your finger above the bump,
and push it down.
See that?
You push it down, man. Now I'm selling Kool-Aid guy. Oh, yeah, baby. Oh, yeah.
You know, also, some people say it sounds like a pedophile, like,
yo, come here, little boy, I got some Minecraft in my bed.
That just sounds too creepy. You know, it was funny, too. I was like, I've done that, and it was funny. I don't know what that is. Like, seriously.
Yo, my name's Tyro Magnus. I'm your brother in the hood, man.
I don't know. I just do my own thing. I bet if I did that in the hood, I bet I'd get shot. I wouldn't let... you're asking for it. I mean, oh my god. Don't, even if they're nice people, don't provoke them, because you pick the wrong person, you're gonna get popped sideways. Oh, you turned it sideways! It's a kill shot! It's a kill shot! Anyway. Okay, so that's the Kool-Aid guy. So we went to Transformer, Microsoft Sam, Uncle Carlos, Asian Boy, Southern Tucker, Kool-Aid guy, now Creepy Laugh. Now this gets people's attention all the time, I don't know why. People have their own references of what they... Okay, people have their own references of what that could be. So it sounds like this. So it's basically like the principle of Uncle Carlos. Watch. They go, except it's so good. Like,
you push it in, it makes it sound like the Mexican.
You push it down, it's like the Kool-Aid guy.
But you push it up, it makes your voice really high, like you're on helium.
So basically what I do is, I go, and then basically laugh like it. And it's like, what the hell is that? And see, it sounds even more creepy when you can't see my face, but that's how I'm doing it. Yeah, that's basically how I do the laugh. Now, on to the next thing here. I've got Creepy Laugh, Stitch and Smeagol. Now, Stitch and Smeagol, while they're right beside each other, because they're really not that far off. Oh, I forgot to put Yoda in here.
They're up the shelf, fuck you must. One of the force you are. A boner I have.
No, something like that. No, I don't want to do that. Okay. Okay, so let's see here. Stitch and Smeagol. It's like, oh, how does Framble? Framble doesn't know what that's for it. You ever hear what it sounds like when Stitch has orgasm? Lillar against the burner, get the orgasm! You know, so I'm like, ugh! It's like, people are like, what the hell? No, you're ruining my childhood by making Stitch act that way. I'm like, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. Yeah, no, it's a Smeagol, right? He's not that far from Stitch. So I mean, let me make an example. Or my princess, Stitch with the princess. And then also he's a Smeagol. My princess, your senses are humans, you're in the sewer. Basically like that. Like, you're not touching the princess. See, I told you. They're kind of that off. Smeagol's just 10% more demonic than Stitch. I'll give you that right now. Okay. That's Stitch and Smeagol. Now, Family Guy. These are fairly new. These were requests I got online. People wanted me to be Peter Griffin. Like, shut up, Mick. So I'm working on it still. Like, hey, Lois, come over here. And I was like, you know, like, how you doing, Mick? I love you. Something like that, right? But seriously, I only know how to do small dialogue for now. But I can do Cleveland Brown. I'm more flexible than Cleveland Brown. Okay. Because I have that kind of voice. But I got Joe. Hey, Peter, come over here. I want to tell you something. You see, Peter, I haven't had sex with Bonnie since I lost my leg 6 years ago. Stuff like that, right? Like, oh my god. Yeah, but basically, Joe, like, hey, Peter, I sound like country boy from South Carolina. See, this is basically the country guy. I'm just tweaking it a little bit from the previous voice. Now, we got Cleveland. Yeah, my name is Cleveland Brown. I'm proud to say that I'm gay. Alas, just nasty. I mean, sometimes I get a little bit more vibrant. Alas, just nasty. Like, it's a go, meh. No, it's not like that. But Cleveland doesn't sound like that. You're like, no. Oh, it's alright, yo. I'm sorry, Loretta, but I can't marry you. But I'll see here. Okay, Family Guy voices. Mating calls. Oh, this is gonna be a lovely one. Okay, here. Okay. Mating calls. Horse. This one's pretty simple. It's sucking in. Like that, right? Yeah, it's like. I don't know, I just do it. And, I can do a goat. And then there's just a sheep. Let's go to like that. Just they're slightly off and slightly off sync from one another. And yeah, so those are mating calls. And I got dinosaur calls, of course. And I got my own signature mating call that me and Kat were working with. Okay. So anyway, yeah. So I was talking to my friend about this, and he's like, "So yeah," I was like saying like, "Yeah, you know, it's funny. I actually have my own mating calls. Like, you know, if I want to woo someone, I'm not gonna say, hey, what the fuck? I'm like, no, I'm gonna be like, I'm gonna do my mating call instead. I'm more primitive than that. I am so far primitive from actually telling you I want to have intercourse versus just like, hey, babe, what the fuck? I'm gonna tap that ass. No, I'm just like, instead of that, I'm just taking my equivalency. That's like a, or sorry. And it's like, what the hell is that? Oh, that's my mating call. That means I want to have sex. Like, oh, okay. That's like, you know, if you think about it, like, you know, it's like your own form of Morse code. Anyway, so I got, like, pterodactyl. Also, you know, it's funny. I actually have, with that said and done, actually, imagine this. Put yourself in a horror movie scenario. You're walking through the dark woods with nothing but a flashlight, almost pitch black. And you feel like you're being followed. Everywhere you go, you feel like something's out to attack you. And when you're almost out of the forest, you hear an earth-shattering scream that sounds like this. And they're like, you're like, oh my god, I don't even know what's real anymore. But seriously, man. That'd be pretty scary. But here's the one that, this is actually going to be on my, one of my latest videos for Omegle Trolling. I actually worked on an improved demonic growl. This one's actually pretty creepy, huh? Let's see if I get this working. Watch. There we go, that's the guttural. Yeah, and trust me, with the scary makeup that I've done, if you don't know how creepy I look with the scary makeup, go to Children of the Night on one of my videos and you'll have the idea. Because if you actually go to near the end, you'll see how scary I get. In this new video, I'm actually 10 times more scary than that. And check this out. Wait, let me see. One more time. Yeah, it's basically this really creepy growl. Like, seriously, if I were to, like, mating call for a demon, like, oh god, I got a succubus! No, not like that. Let's set aside from that. Okay, here's the next one. Okay, mating calls. Yeah, I got a few more. Oh, I got bird. Oh, piggy. I'll say, I got this. Oh, yeah, I forgot to do that. Okay, so a lot of my friends invite me to other friends' lobbies, like, try to make my friend laugh, and their friends actually put up their anti-laughing shields. They're trying to challenge me to get them to laugh, and I actually found out there is a kill switch to make them laugh. All you gotta do is this. Watch this.
I'm a woman, baby. Can't you tell?
Yeah, it's funny. Like,
I'm a woman, baby. Can't you tell?
Well, I don't know if that's loud because I don't have playback. Because I would put playback on the mic, but because it causes too much echo on my computer. So let me push it back a little farther.
I'm a woman, baby. Can't you tell?
And I'm like, what the fuck? And I'm just like,
oh yeah, baby.
Hold on.
Oh yeah, baby. Talk dirty to me.
Like, what the hell is that? Hold on. Let me try one more time.
Oh yeah, baby, talk dirty to me.
There we go. That's decent. There's other days. So here's the problem. I recently woke up. I recently just woke up, so my voice isn't exact. I have to warm my pipes to make them work. That's how it works, man. Okay, and, okay, what's we got here? Okay, da-da-da-da-da.
Those mating calls.
Now, here's the ultimate ammunition. Here's the ultimate ammunition of the voices that I do. This one's called the feminine guy. This makes people crawl out of their skin because it makes them very uncomfortable. And you thought the voice alone was enough to creep you out? You should see, yeah, you're going to see my face when I do this. Okay, because I've actually been around very feminine dudes before. I'm not making fun of them. I'm just imitating them and showing you how I reflect how I see them. Okay. That still sounds racist. But anyway. No, just, I don't know what, sexist. I don't know. Okay, a feminine guy. And I put a hash here. See those little black marks, little hash things right there? They're bold. Those are like sliced off, like categories. So it says, feminine guy, slash, fabulous.
This is quite simple. So simple, I'm already doing the fabulous guy voice, but I can also tweak it into many different ways to make it sound even better.
You see, it's funny. So I have head movement, and I got the arm gestures. And it's like,
oh my god, the sweet Jesus, what am I looking at? And it's like, Jessica, where are you?
Just like that, right? I mean, I actually did that in one of my Vines, like, not Vine, YouTube video. This guy was staring at a pitch black room, and I was doing scary trolling. And I was like, my head was down, like,
Jessica, how are you doing?
And I was like, oh my god, you scared the crap out of me. That's fine. Yeah, but seriously, I can tweak it up and make it almost sound like a Valley Girl. Like, you know, Gabriel Iglesias, the comedian, you know, he's a Mexican, very big. And I don't know, something about him is just very funny when he's a big guy. I don't know. But, yeah, but basically, it's like, welcome to McDonald's. I'm going to take care of
oh my god, yes! I have burgers, some fries, and a shake.
And they are not expecting me, man. I pull up, it's like, did you eat this already?
Oh my god, yes!
It's like, oh my god, man, that's creepy. You're seeing my face when I'm doing this. Yeah.
You know what's actually kind of crazy? Before I even did this YouTube video, I was trying to contemplate if I should eat something. That's why in the beginning of the video, you saw me drinking AMW root beer. Because, oh my god, I'm so into that licorice flavor.
No, oh, listen.
Also, I got a Domino's pizza slice here. And some little mozzarella balls.
No, I mean, that's creepy. I'm not going to do that ever. You don't have to see that. I probably scarred you, but it's fine.
Yeah, but seriously, that is my feminine voice, and I think it's so fabulous.
Some people actually contemplate if I'm gay, but... You know, it's fine. My friends ask me that, like, are you gay? I'm like, and I respond with this. My signature response, only on Tuesdays. Are you gay? Only on Tuesdays. You gonna fuck me in the butt? Only on Tuesdays. Stuff like that, I'm just like... I just do that every time, man. Every time. Okay. Next thing. Next one on here. Okay, feminine guy. Oh, Arnold Schwarzenegger. This one's a. And he's like, I'll get the one to be Arnold. I can totally be Arnold if you want me to.
Get to be Chopper. Come with us. You are so amazing, Arnold. We need you. You come with us to get that surprise. We can get out of here, man. So he's like, get to be Chopper.
If you make the too long, you make him sound like autistic Arnold. You don't want that. Unless that's what you're going for. So basically, you know what's sad about when I could talk like Arnold? You know what's funny is that when I talk like Arnold Schwarzenegger, it's sad because he sounds nothing like that. Anybody who impersonates Arnold Schwarzenegger is emphasizing his voice. He has like a slight Austrian accent,
and we emphasize that so much.
Like seriously, like, you know, like, for example, like, in the movie, like, Terminator, I'll be back. Like, that, I'll be back. Instead of, like, I'll be back! Like, that, I was like, oh my god. We're emphasizing how much of the accent we're putting out of his voice. It's like, it's stupid. Okay, that's basically Arnold. That's one I'm okay at doing. Now, this one's a little bit creepy. I kind of know how to talk like a German because of this commercial. The Toaster Strudel commercial. Another little German kid, blonde hair, bright blue eyes, wears a lederhosen. He's like 11 years old. And he's looking at people like he's gonna rape them, kind of fake look. And it was fine. So basically it's like the guy, crunchy, creamy, flaky, toaster strudel. It kind of sounds like a feminine German. I'm not gonna lie. But I don't think it's the guy, crunchy, creamy, flaky, toaster strudel. Yeah, so basically, with that reference, I'm learning how to replicate a German accent.
Und uns wie Heiden!
No, it's like, wir uns wie der Talker next to Germans! You know, it's funny, like,
this is why uns, you do not piss off the Germans!
And you also gotta make sure you're on point, because you'll make yourself sound like a little Asian part of South Korea.
Because they saw how they were mixed up with the Germans and the Asian.
So basically, you have your own specific dialect, but in comparison to the Asian and the German. Yeah.
Pizza!
No, 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 no. Forget what you saw. No. I am not a Nazi. Okay. Okay, next one on the list here. British. This one's actually pretty signature. I'm actually pretty good at doing this. And so the problem with this is, you have to be a little bit smart about how you do these voices. Because, it's not the fact of how you do them, it's how you execute the sound. Because people can easily mistake a British guy for Australian. I mean, seriously. So I'm just like, so British people are mistaken for Australians. Because that's typical Americans. They always like to mistake the British people for Australians. I don't understand. The Australians are like the British rejects of who knows gold, but so what? I don't even know. Stuff like that. You know what's funny? I actually realized I checked my analytics on YouTube. I have like a 20% crowd that's like watching from the UK. I'm like, oh, Jesus and a blood sword Christ. You know what's funny? I actually talk to British friends and I talk like that. And they know they sound nothing like that. Because I sound like a British royalty guy who's like a spoiled brat, like born with a silver spoon in his mouth. You know, I was really like,
yeah, get out of here, Sir Walter. I'm Sir Lancelot, very close friends with King Arthur, the Land of Camelot. I would like to invite you to the Buckingham Palace with Queen Victoria II so we can have an afternoon tea party. If you do refuse to attend, I'm going to have the Royal Guard shove a crumpet up your arse with a strike on air. You don't want that. And if you still continue to refuse, I'm going to get a bottle of tapatio sauce. I'm going to shove it up your arse and funnel it down your buttock. And how do you scream like hell?
See, that's basically my own version. That's my own version of, like, talking British. And here's the thing, too. Talking in a British accent can be very, addicting. Because even though when I go back to my normal voice, a slight British accent will still maintain. And it's very annoying. So even I can't turn it off even when I go back to talking normal. Now, let's see, here's the thing, too.
When I talk British, this is what, if I talk like this, you're going to automatically assume I live in London. No, I live in the Whitechapel region. Of course, why won't I?
But seriously, let's check this out now. So that's British. Anybody can easily classify that as British. Now, here's the other thing now. Australian.
So it's basically British.
All you gotta do is just drop it down and mention on it.
Let's see, like that. It's like, how you doing, old mate? My name's also... It's like, you just do something like that, right? And like, I don't know. It's like, imagine, like, Yeah, it's kind of tough. I don't really know much dialogue between Australians, but I know, like, there's certain things you say. Like, they're like, hey, the mutt. It's like, let's go to a donut. Let's go ahead. And all of a sudden, like, you'd be like, it's like, hey, the mutt, can you pass me the tomato sauce? I can put on my chips. And all of a sudden, it's like, yeah, tomato sauce, ketchup, and chips are basically fries. They're like, hey, the mutt, can you pass me the tomato sauce so I can get some chips too? Something like that. So basically, you want to basically drop your octave down a little wee bit. And you also want to slow your words, just squat a bit more. So you basically sound like an Australian. He's like, could I tell you, mate? See, basically, you also sound like an Australian. See, that's kind of how it works. Yeah, so like, you know, something basic, you might. You want to put on your toes and your thongs and head out to the beach and go surfing all day long. You know, just try just a little bit of notification, mate. I know you're new here, but don't try not to hit the Great Barrier Reef. It's made of coral. If you scrape yourself on coral, you might as well amputate your leg, because coral is actually a bunch of little microscopic fish that like to eat away at your flesh. Oh, and try to look out for the pinch of jellyfish. The venom can kill you in exactly a minute if you don't get the antidote immediately. Okay, but seriously, that's basically my Australian. Now, oh my god. Batman. We got a Batman one now. We got a Batman impersonation. This is something I'm doing. Okay, so out of all the Batman movies, everybody chooses to imitate Batman to the Dark Knight movie of 2007 with Heath Ledger Joker. He's like, I'm Bruce Wayne. But Heath Ledger? Batman, all that?
I'm Batman. I'm the Dark Knight. I hate the Joker. When we were in elementary school, he stole my milk on my lunch tray. He took my cookies. When at recess time, we'd go out and play. He would always beat me at Foursquare. Ugh, he pissed me off.
I wish I had a Batman mask. Like,
and seriously, he was such a bully to me. He's like, oh, your parents are dead. Ugh. Oh, like, isn't your life is any better?
You know, and then I do stuff like, I actually think that this thing will stop after a half hour, I think, last time I checked. And here we go. I'm almost done with the list, so hopefully I can make... I'll make two parts if needed. And then basically... And then so I'm just like,
I hate the Joker. He always gave me wet willies and purple nurples. And also, he also gave me atomic wedgies all the time. But guess what? I'm Batman. I have millions of dollars. And look at you, you little clown. You're sitting behind the jail cell. Who's amazing now?
Okay, anyway, that's my joke. That's that version of Batman. I also got Dash right across from Batman here's Joker. It's like, I simply believe whatever doesn't kill you simply makes you stronger. Yeah, and obviously it doesn't seem like it would match me, but I actually do wear Joker makeup. If you actually would watch one of my Joker trolls down there, that's my own persona. That's a little bit of, how you doing that, old chappy? I'm quite a psychotic Joker. It's kind of a British Joker, but it's my own persona when I first started doing it. It's like, oh, he's a Batman. How do you know? It's like, it's just stuff like that. He's like, can't you sing a song with me? Oh, the London Bridge is falling down, falling down. That's because I blew it up with 10 tons of C4. Stuff like that. You won't give me a psychotic eyes when you do it. Yeah. Okay, and Vietnam veteran, basically, / old guy. So it was like,
you know, I don't understand the young generation these days. I mean, seriously, you got this, think of a Jenny here. It's an iPhone made by some Apple. I didn't know people at the grocery store sold apples and cell phones. And, it has no buttons. It's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's only 5 buttons. I don't understand how it works. But, you know, I had a flip phone back in the 80s. Yeah, this is what I had back in the day.
Like, oh, it was funny. I imagine when I got Bakugan during Christmas, my grandfather, I opened up one of the Bakugan on the magnetic card.
That thing is possessed by a demon! The Japanese are possessed! The demons have possessed Japanese toys! It's a conspiracy to take over America!
I'm like, oh my god. It was actually funny, 2% of my crowd is actually 60 years and older. So I can imagine, I can imagine the other old guys.
That is not what I sound like! Really?
Anyway. Yeah, so I think I got 5 seconds until this video ends. So hold on, give it a second. Oh, it's still going. I think it's like a five... Oh, I thought it actually stopped. I thought it stopped at, Actually, I think it stops at an hour. Yeah, I think that's correct. Okay, never mind. We got plenty of time.
We got plenty of time.
Okay. Okay, Thunderman, German toaster, British, Australian, Batman Joker, Vietnam veteran, and, oh, Indian, of course. This is just a stereotype, not being racist. Like, oh my god, my friend, take a recording, get a customer support. My name is Rokesh. If you have any questions about your third customer support laptop, all you have to do is call our support center. We're open 24 hours a day, not including the holidays, but seriously. That's funny. I'm actually going to tell you a funny quick story. That's the Indian guy, right? You know, like, oh my god, my friend, something like that. So, this is ridiculous. You know, I actually got some reference off Lunch Break. He's like, oh, I'm not ugly, how are you doing? Something like that. And so, you know that stereotype? I don't know if you guys know the stereotype, but I actually know this one pretty well. It's basically when you walk into a 7-Eleven, you got that Middle Eastern guy trying to sell you a Slurpee. He's like, welcome to 7-Eleven, would you like to buy a Slurpee? And all of a sudden, it was funny. I thought that was just a myth. It was just a stereotype. You know, it's like saying, like, Asians know karate. I mean, it's something like that, you know. But, yeah, it's basically a stereotype like that, but this actually was confirmed. This was a real deal. Because I walked into a, I think it was a 7-Eleven. But I walked in, because I needed to get some gas, right? I was gonna, you know, do that, and I also decided to get some stuff, you know, because I was going on a road trip. And I remember this guy. He's like, thank you for coming to 7-Eleven, do you want to go buy a Slurpee? I'm like, we got $25. I'm like, you know, it's funny, I felt like a racist prick for doing this, and I just turned around like this. Oh my god. I did that to him. That was my response. Like, dude, my friend, what are you acting like that for? Are you Indian? I'm like, no, I just like to imitate you. God damn. I'm such a prick for doing that. I mean, you know, it's actually funny. I mean, technically, if I think about it, I'm actually not racist. Because I'm actually, by the state, I'm actually considered insane. I'm actually not sane at all. I'm far from it. And a lot of friends can relate. I can tell you that much. You know, it's funny. You know, it's like, you know, when you got the crazy guy, it's kind of like, you know, keep the sharp objects away from that kid. He's going to snap one day, and he's going to butcher a lot of people. You know, for me, it's like, keep the cheese wedges away from a man. Still take the cheese wedge and shove it up your butt. And yeah, it's like, and that's how my psychotic brain, feel the wrath of my ass wedge. You're going to get anally inserted by a block of Swiss cheese. That's me. You don't have to worry about the sharp objects, I mean, seriously. Oh, I'm set aside from that. Okay, next thing here. Vietnam veteran, Indian guy. Boston guys. These are Boston guys. This is something I referenced off of. This is something I'm an apprentice level at this. I'm still working with this. So what you're about to hear is two dialogue conversations between two friends going to a grocery store, ready to go on a camping trip. So basically, they're trying to buy some s'mores, trying to find the ingredients to get s'mores. So it goes like this. Hey, Obani, get some of the graham crackers so we can have some s'mores. Okay, sure thing. Videos you got to do is get the models and the chocolate boards. Stuff like that, right? Yeah, stuff like that. So that's basically like a Boston accent, as far as I'm concerned. Last time I checked, that was accurate. And also, set aside from that, I mean, this is like, yo, man, I'm from Brooklyn, man. I sell canoles on the corner to get myself a... I sell canoles on the... God damn it.
I can't keep a straight face. I saw cannolis on the corner for a quarter. He's like, hold on, I know you took my daughter's cannoli fifth and Broadway.
I hope I'm not pissing off New Yorkers. I know you guys are not angry people, you're just East Coasters in comparison to the West Coast. What I do like about East Coasters is that they don't sugarcoat anything for you. That's just how they are by nature. They're not rude, they're not pricks. They're just, that's how they are by nature. And that's actually their definition of being polite. So, yeah. Okay. Okay, let's see here. Boston guys. Okay, now, we pretty much almost covered all of them, all the voices. Now, here's some bonus stuff I'm doing. This is beatbox. A lot of people don't really know if I'm actually beatboxing or I'm playing it through a phone. I mean, seriously, there's quite a difference. I mean, seriously, for example, one. Like bass drum, that's like throat bass in, but bass drum and kick. So basically, here's the thing. When it comes to beatboxing, there's actually three things that are very difficult to do. That's throat bass. The second hardest that'll destroy your throat if you're not doing it correctly is... And that's the inward bass. And that's when you go like...
Drop the beat, plop, plop, stay, rabbit, 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 plop, plop, stay, rabbit, 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 rabbit,
rabbit, rabbit, rabbit, rabbit, rabbit, rabbit, rabbit, rabbit, rabbit, rabbit, rabbit, rabbit, rabbit, rabbit. See, now, okay, I had to give you a second to process what I meant by that. So, like, I can imagine your face, like, oh, God, he just said boner bass. Do I even want to hear this? Like, no, it's perfectly appropriate. It's just basically the word boner, and I add it into a beat. No, it's the parody of drop the bass. Like, you know, drop the bass. Drop the bass. Here's this. Drop the boner, 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 boner. No. Okay. But seriously, that's how it goes.
I think he wants to drop the bonus, sir. Everybody wanna drop, drop, everybody drop that boner.
And you know, sometimes if I want to be more age appropriate around people, I go like this. Jelly bellies. I love jelly beans, okay? The Harry Potter jelly beans. I really love the earwax flavored jelly beans. They should make that an ice cream flavor. Earwax flavored ice cream. I imagine I open up my own ice cream shop. Bootylicious Ice Cream Parlor. Like, people walk in, welcome to Bootylicious Ice Cream Parlor. What can I get you? Question, why is it called Bootylicious Ice Cream? Oh, that's because we got our own signature flavor. It tastes like booty. And like, he's like, really? That's why? I'm like, no, actually, believe it or not, we have a back room. You get the, why eat ice cream in the back. That's why. No, that ain't, it's like, really? That's what you do? Like, this is a weird version of a brothel, man. And no, that's not bad either. But set aside from that, you know, it's only, you know, if you got the booty flavored ice cream, you like chop up human butt cheeks in the back and fuse it into an ice cream flavor. That's basically, you know, vanilla ice cream. Just got a bunch of booty shrapnel in the vanilla ice cream. That's our signature booty flavor. Now, set aside from that, let's not talk about that. And so basically, yeah. And it was funny. People think my beatboxing is fake even when they see my face. Watch this. This is something this is good evidence. Watch this. See that? Right here? Right here, watch. See that? See, now disappear. That's my vein, my artery, my little jugular vein sticking out because I'm pushing all the blood in my head to beatbox. But set aside from that, okay, I'm still trying to wrap this up as quick as possible so I can eat my pizza, you know, eat my pizza. Okay, let's see here. Indian, Boston, beatbox. Okay, narrator. Obviously, narrator is a little bit, A little bit tricky. I mean, seriously, I have to get my mic closer for this. Well, I know also it's like, yabba yabba yo, 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 this your bubba bubba boy, yabba DJ Defno, coming at you live from Seattle, Washington, radio broadcasting Saturday station. Stuff like that, but the original goes like this. Okay. Yabba yabba yo, 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 this your bubba bubba boy, yabba DJ Defno, coming at you live from Seattle, Washington, radio broadcasting station. And I just kind of echo it off. Yeah, broadcasting station. Like that. You just got to kick it off like that. I didn't even need special effects for that, but I made it work. I did make it work, though. I'm going to set aside from that. No. Okay, let's see. We're almost at the bottom of the list here. We're about to wrap this up here pretty quick. Narrator. Now, Optimus Prime. Okay, I'm not talking about the transform we did at the beginning of the video. Like the...
Optimus Prime.
No, that is my generic version, okay? I don't know why people think it's Optimus Prime. In terms of how accurate it is to the Michael Bay movie, not even close. Well, let's get that off the table now. There's this YouTuber, a beatboxer that I look up to. His name is Ozellus, and he's kind of like... Okay, there are two beatboxers I look on YouTube that I reference some stuff off of. I don't learn from other beatboxers. I just learn how to make the sounds, and I do my own material. I don't mimic anything they do. The only reason why I'm mimicking this, what Ozellus does, is because I want to figure out how I can freely talk like that. And since that's the only reference he really does in that, in all of his Omega video things he does, and on Call of Duty Trolling with Jericho, then basically, I only have a few lines to go off of. But with my creative mind, I'm pretty sure I can make my own dialogue. So let me get the mic closer, because it sounds much better on my gaming headset, so I'm probably going to put this right here.
Hi, I'm Optimus Prime. Autobots, transform, and rub, 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 Autobots, transform, and rub, 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 roll out.
Something like that, right? Well, but Ozellus does a vocal strike like that. No, I know how he does that. But I prefer to do my own version because I don't want to be the guy who's copyright. You know, I don't want to hijack off someone else's success. You know, I try when I'm a YouTuber, I try to be selfless about that kind of stuff. You know what I mean? But anyway. Yeah, so, like, you know, let me do it one more time.
Hi, I'm Optimus Prime.
Listen, I can push it harder. Hold on.
Hi, I'm Optimus Prime. Autobots, transform and roll out. We are the Autobots. We are waiting here amongst the stars.
You know, when you're kind of talking with the R's, it's like,
R's, R.
Or I'm, like, Optimus Prime, like,
Optimus Prime.
When you do that, it kind of gives up the accent, the way how he talks in the Michael Bay movie. It's like,
hi, I'm Optimus Prime, Autobots, step in a transform, and rub and roll out.
Yeah, but set aside from that, yeah. Oh, also, yeah, this works too. My demon voice kind of substitutes for Megatron.
Give me the cue, boy, and you may live to be my pet.
Something like that, right?
You may live to be my pet.
I don't know. I don't even know if that sounds good. I mean, I have no feedback, so I can't tell until I watch the video. But I think I know him just okay, you know? And I also get the slightest feeling that you can't stop staring at what's at the bottom of my chin, this little bush here. Yeah, and also, and some people have been wondering how old I am. Bro, I'm 14. Okay, so that's basically the entire list. Now, here are some bonus things for the next upcoming video. Okay, a new video I have in mind, a Q&A. If you don't know what that is, it's a question and answer. Basically, you guys leave a question in this video that you're watching. Leave a question in this video and ask me a question about me, you know what I mean? So basically, guys, it's a Q&A about me. Get to know me, okay? The reason why I want to do a Q&A. The reason why, there'll be a few of these over the time I'm doing YouTube, but ask as many questions away. Ask away. I don't care if it's the same person asking like 10 questions. I'll ask them to the best of my abilities. So at the bottom of this video, just leave a comment down below of what questions you want to know about me. For example, anything you want. Okay, but yeah, so I want to get to know me. Because the reason why is, you know, when I have a crowd that's about to push 400 followers, I need to know what you guys want. And I don't like being a stranger to you guys. You only know me for all this crazy insanity that I do on Xbox Live. And on Omegle for some of the crowd that's watching. and with some of my friends in real life, but you only know me for that side. If you want to know specific questions, personal, if I can answer them to the best of my abilities, I'll be happy to tell you these questions. Now, so the reason why I'm doing a Q&A video, because I want you to get to know me, and I want to get to know you guys, because I feel like if I tell you some stuff about me, I feel like we would have a closer bond, because at the bottom of this thing right here, it's a pretty sentimental quote I made myself, you know. And this, because when it comes to being a YouTuber, I'm very humble. I'm not intending to be the next PewDiePie. I mean, people say I should be. I'm like 150,000% underrated is what they said, but, you know, they're just like, you should be more popular with the kind of crazy, like, hilariousness you have. You should be up there with Jacksepticeye and Markiplier and PewDiePie. I'm like, well, so the problem about that is, it's not up to me. It's up to you guys. It's up to you, depending on how viral I should go. Because there's this thing called the viral effect. One person watches that video. He decides to share it with all of his friends and family. All of his friends and family share it with their friends and family. It starts multiplying like a virus, a sickness on the internet. And then basically that's how the viral effect works. But I haven't even got that far yet. I no one's sent me viral. I mean, I'm not asking you to, but if you guys want me to be bigger, I mean, it's not up to me, you know what I mean? I can make like 3,000 videos on my channel, but at the end of the day, it's up to you guys if you want to share my content or determine where I should go, you know? Because it's kind of a two-way street, you know? It's a 50-50. I make content for you to watch, and it's up to the audience to share with other people or if they should at all. But, set aside from that, I'm almost pushing 400 subs. And at the end of the day, and one day if I wake up and I have 150,000, I'm still going to remain as humble. I would like to think I remain as humble as I am now. Seriously. Because I prefer to have that genuine bond, okay? And, that's what the Q&A is about. It's a bonding thing between bros. And, obviously women too, because apparently I have quite a female crowd. Not that I'm ruling you guys. Oh, sorry about that, I sneezed. It's basically to get to know me between you ladies and gents. I just want to form a bond with you guys. And so basically my quote is this. My subscribers mean more to me than a number. With many YouTubers, they just don't get it. There's no possible way you can be successful on YouTube if you just treat your subs like it's a trophy and a reward, you know? Because here's how I look at it. If I ended up having 1 million subs, I would like to think that they're all my friends, you know what I mean? Not just something that gets me a paycheck, you know? I don't care about being paid on YouTube. I really don't. It's not me, you know? That's not what I'm about. I just figured some people could use some insight and some insanity in their lives, and that's where I come in. I'm kind of like your therapist. Unlicensed, of course, but I'm like the opposite of a therapist. I'm like the anarchist of the internet, and I just totally make people go crazy. That's my job. That is my job! It doesn't pay, of course, but, you know, it's fun to do. Now, yeah, so that's basically that's what you guys mean to me. You're more than just a number. I'll tell you one thing right now. Analytically, of all the stats I have, I bet you anything, 95% of the people that are on my channel, I met you online. I met you guys all online. We've had a nice conversation. We had a great time. You subbed me, so we have that connection. Of course, if I ever get big enough, not everybody has met me personally through the internet or in real life. But I would still like to have that connection with someone I haven't been with online before. Yeah, so, you know, my subs mean more to me than a number. You're more than just a number. I'm not going to show off. See, that's the thing. I don't care if I have 400 or if I have 4 million. Okay? I mean, and honestly, you know, I actually think of it this way, too. But, I mean, if I ever do get big, I it really doesn't matter. If it happens, it happens. But right now, I'm actually kind of comfortable with my small channel. But do send me a rattle if you want to. You know what I mean? But yeah, I'm actually, you know, I feel like a small channel is actually kind of good because you don't have as much obligation. You have a bigger crowd expecting more things from me. The bigger you are, the bigger the demand and supply and demand. And you have to, the consumers are more demanding of all your content they want. They want improvements. They want recommendations. You kind of become an obligation. That's what PewDiePie was talking about in his previous months, too. He was talking about how he didn't want to do vlogs anymore because people wanted them, but nobody really cared, you know, so he just kind of stopped doing it. Something like that. He doesn't like feeling obligated. You know what's funny? PewDiePie, whew, PewDiePie is an amazing YouTuber. I was, like, literally, like, I was in the 4 million sub category. Like, I was one of the, you know, like, from 3 million to 4 million subs. And, it doesn't seem like a lot. Like, I will tell you right now, I was indeed there before many of those other 50 million followers were there to watch him. I watched him progress quite a bit. But, yeah, he's actually an amazing YouTuber. And, Markiplier, oh my god, his choice of words makes him so witty. I don't know what it is. He has, like, a certain energy that PewDiePie doesn't have, but PewDiePie has a certain sense of humor. Yeah, you know, and Jacksepticeye, he's funny as hell sometimes, but the problem with him is, I don't know, I highly doubt Jacksepticeye would be watching this, but, I like Jacksepticeye, but the one problem is his voice. I mean, I like him, but I have to take breaks from watching him, because if I watch him too long, his voice kind of gets annoying. Don't get me wrong, I like Irish people, I really do. I love his ecstatic intro. I can't do his voice, but, you know, that's the best I can do. Yeah, but I can do what? PewDiePie? That's my voice impression here. Watch this. Hasakon Brush, my name is PewDiePie. That's like the old PewDiePie, way before. It's like, Hasakon Brush, my name is PewDiePie. Yeah, it's like it's when he had that thick Swedish accent before he started, you know, kind of moving over to our English, kind of. You know, it's funny, I actually learned how to speak Swedish through PewDiePie. I only know, like, one line. I was talking to a Swedish guy on Omegle, and what happened was, I was talking to a Swedish guy on Omegle, and he's like, "You Swedish?" I'm like, "No, I'm not Swedish." And he's like, "Yo, you look like a Swedish guy." And all of a sudden, I just dropped. I didn't even know what I was saying. I just knew I was swearing. I was like, "Oh, jävla, vad I helvete!" And all of a sudden, the guy's like, "Hey!" He's like, "You're Swedish?" I'm like, "Actually, no." I'm like, "How did you know how to say that?" I'm like, "I watched PewDiePie." I'm like, "Well, you swear like a Swedish man pretty good then." I'm like, "Okay, whatever." Yeah, but, yeah, so that's the next video after this. Leave a question down below of what you want to know about me in the next video. I need to get to a certain amount of questions. So ask away, man. Ask as many questions. Ask to your heart's content, because if I don't have enough questions, I can't make the video. So the faster you make your questions, the faster that video will come out so you can understand who I am. Of course, yeah. Okay, yeah, so, like, I'll say it before and I'll say it again, because this is just how I am. My subscribers mean more to me than a number. Basically meaning I don't see you guys as a number, I see you guys as family, kind of. Yeah, because, you know, there's some funny content in my life, and here's something I learned, is that, you know, the funny stuff you see me do, like the funny compilations you see me playing video games, it's funny, by all means. A lot of my friends crack up and stuff like that. But, you know, if I were to show my parents or something like that, or any of my family, like my grandmother or my grandfather, anything like that, they don't laugh because they see me as their, you know, their relative. You know, they don't see me as an entertainer. They don't see me as a comedian, apparently. But that's where I get the sensation from you guys. You guys kind of get it because you don't know me like they do. So I can actually tell without the judgment of being a family, you know. You guys are my family, sort of. Well, I mean, I don't have a certificate for all 400 of you. Like, we're all brothers and sisters. If it's any consolation, we are all brothers and sisters to the eyes of the Lord. That just sounded weird. Yeah, we're all brothers and sisters to the eyes of God. You don't believe it for atheists, but... Well, this is an expression, okay. Basically, that's all I have on the list here. Yeah. So that's all I have for you guys. Oh, yeah, so I really don't know what to talk about. Oh, yeah, there's a couple things I do would like to show you, though. Yeah, so I showed you my voice impressions, the beatboxing that I do, the proof that everything I showed you was legitimate. And I'm sorry, the video had to take almost an hour long. But hey, it was kind of required. It kind of was. And check this out, though. Hold on, watch this. Watch this. I do this on Omegle sometimes. People think I'm, like, snapping my fingers to make this happen. But watch this. It's just something honest. It's a small activity that I do. Okay. Hand, right? Okay. Hand. Okay. Can you guess what finger this is? Can you guess what finger that is? Nope, you were wrong. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, can you guess what finger this is? Can you guess what finger that is? No, can't. Can you guess what finger this is? Nope, you're wrong. Well, okay, enough joking around. This is something you guys should try doing. This is like, you know, this should be like our secret code, you know? Like something that, you know, like, do you watch DJ Death Note? I'm just like, yeah, okay, then what's his signature hand sign? Like, what is his signature hand sign? And watch this. Watch, ready? Hold on. Oh, just snapped, okay. Here we go. La-la-dee-da-dee-da-da-da-da-da-da. There you go. That is my signature hand sign. This is the code for I watch your channel. Yeah, it kind of looks like a swastika, but I don't say I'm a Nazi. Just because I talk like a German in my frickin' narrow voice impressions doesn't mean I'm a Nazi. Be hiding. No, I'm just kidding. Anyway. Yeah, that is my thing. So basically how to make it is pretty simple. So it's like that. So watch what I do. Take your finger, bend it all the way around like that. And then do that. Like that. See, like that. You got it like that. And boom, boom. See? Like that. Wrap it over and put your thumb over your index finger and put it under that finger. And then voila. You weaved a knot into your hands. There you go. That is my signature code. Maybe it's not good enough. I mean, I don't know. How about this? Watch this. Maybe that's not good enough. Maybe try this. I don't know. I'm having fun here. I don't know why. Also, there's one more thing I would like to add. When people actually hear that weird noise, like that, that is a legitimate thing. It's like my own form of Tourette's. It only happens when I get excited. Whenever I get excited for some odd reason, when I get amped, I have spastic convulsions in my tongue, just random little twitches and stuff like that. And usually I exert that through making that sound to calm down. And so, yeah, it's kind of like, you know, like it's making the yuh sound, like yuh, 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 like that. And I'm like, what the hell are you doing, man? You're like, you got Tourette's? I'm like, maybe. Yeah, also, here's my something, too, is that poker face, man. I play poker. I don't know why this is completely relevant. I'm just going to finish off this last thing, and I'm going to end the video off, because I know it's going to cut off after an hour, so. Yeah, so basically, when I'm playing poker, you know, you have to have a good poker face, right? You have to have a good poker face. And some of you guys give me a good poker face. You get your cards, you're just like, royal flush. Right? Or if you're just like that guy who gets a royal flush in his hand, he's like, oh, and then the other guy's looking around like, oh, guy's got a good hand. I'm not betting any money. But you know, it's funny. This is, okay, bad poker face. Good poker face. You know, it's funny. Right? You don't know what my poker face is? It's not good or bad. It's just freaking creepy. I'll be looking at my cards. I'm just like, did you guys hear that? That's my stomach. I'm hungry. Okay. But anyway, so like I said before, I'm holding my cards. This is my poker face. That's this creepy man.
Can you see my eyes? Can you see my eyes? The eyes are the window to your soul, and I'm looking into yours.
That's creepy. Let's set aside from that, man. My name is DJ Death Note. Don't forget to like, don't forget to sub, and for God's sakes, leave a comment down below. The more comments you leave down below, the more I feel like I can connect with you, because I try my best to respond to every question that I can. I try my best to respond to every question. So, without further ado, you guys, stay awesome. Ooh. This is a very important announcement. Do leave questions for a Q&A video down in the comment section. It helps me and helps you guys out very much to get to know who I am. Thank you for watching.